Well, if you wait long enough, a lot of trends will come back around. So it was a bit premature 30 years ago when we pronounced the death of vinyl records. Here's now State Representative Dan Howell in the summer of 91. Vinyl
records anymore? Been a long, long, long time ago when I bought a vinyl record. Probably about close to 10 years, I'd say. Yeah, nobody buys those no more.
Scott Moore isn't alone. The new technology in cassettes and CDs have taken vinyl records out of the stores and off the air.
24 hours a day of the most beautiful music in the world.
WDEF Radio's Chris Thomas says record labels don't send vinyl to the stations anymore.
Vinyl is very scarce nowadays. CDs, like I say, the clarity is great and you can't burn them out. So I think they'll be around for a while.
Most record labels, such as CBS, don't even make vinyl records anymore. All your stars are heard on cassette and CD. And at record stores, such as Turtles, well, we couldn't find a vinyl recording in the entire place. And the manager here says you probably couldn't find one in Chattanooga.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away.
But vinyl recordings are still in demand, and people find them at shops like this, Blast from the Past in East Ridge.
We'll be open until 7 o'clock tonight.
The shop specializes in 50s and 60s rock and roll, records that have become as collectible as coins and stamps.
But with a record, if you take care of it, have a great needle, you're going to be able to use it for what it was meant to and still collect it, and it'd be valuable someday.
For example, the jacket on this Beatle album is worth $400, and that's a big reason why vinyl records are still in demand today. With the Mobile Newsroom, Dan Howell, News Center 12.